So in this example, I'm going to demonstrate the time division multiplexing TDM of two audio signals. Specifically, I have selected two audio signals. The first one is drum music 1.wav, that is, it's a wav file, and the second one is drum music 2.wav. So I would use the function audioread to read this file and extract the information y1 and the sampling rate fs1, and also I would get some relevant information by means of audio info, that is, for this file I would get all the information info1. So until keyboard in the line 7, let us run this simulation. So we have two number of channels, so this means that this is a stereo channel. The sampling rate is set to 44.1 kHz. The total number of samples are 252432, and note that since it's stereo, so this means that we would have this many rows and two columns, right? And then the duration is 5.7241, right? So let us play this audio. Similarly, I'm going to read the second audio file and do some processing. So this is the information for our second audio file. Again, we have a stereo audio. The sampling rate is consistent, that is 44.1 kHz, and total number of samples and duration is mentioned. Note that the duration of the second audio is less than that of the first audio, and consequently the total number of samples for audio 2 is less than that of 252432 in the first audio. So as a first step, I'm going to append zeros to the second audio. So this means that y1 is a 252432 by 2 matrix, which is mentioned over here, and similarly y2 is two, three, nine, eight, four, two by two matrix. So y2 is smaller than y1 in terms of the number of rows. So this block is actually missing in y2. So to make them consistent, what I'm going to do is I'm going to append this block with zeros so that both of them have the same length. That is this one, right? And for that, what I have done is in line 14, I have taken the difference, that is the size of y1 minus size of y2. So this is going to give me the difference. So based on this difference, that is 12590 by 0. So I would select the first element, that is 12590, which is over here, difference of 1, 2. So this means that the zeros would be 12590 and 0. So all of these zeros would then be appended to y2, which was having less number of samples. This is expressed in line number 17 of the code. So y2 colon, so this means it will go into the number of rows and append all of these zeros. So, and then I have expressed the dimensions of y2 by means of whose y2, and over here you can observe that y2 is 252432. This is exactly similar to the total number of samples, 252432 by the number of channels 2. So y2 is now consistent with y1. Let us play the second audio file. Now we have two audio files. The first one is y1 and the other one is y2. Now the first audio signal, that is y1, is having a matrix which is a1, a2, an, and b1, b2, bn, where the rows are total number of samples times the columns identifying the stereo setup, right? So for pre-processing, as a step one, we would convert this into a vector, and for that we would need a1, a2, an. This will be followed by b1, b2, bn. Right? So this would be one row into total number of columns, rows into columns. This would be appearing over here. Right? So this is our step one. In step two, for TDM, I am interested in a recursive element. So for that, I need something like A1, 0, A2, 0, and then AN, 0, and then eventually BN. So after each element, I am including a 0. So all of this is basically expressed in 24 and 25 lines in the MATLAB code. So 24 is a vector of all zeros, and 25 we're going to set y1 at values of 1, and then of the increment of 2, that is 1 3 5 7 9 11, and so on. So the first element would be a1, which will be at 1, then a2 would be at 3, a3 would be at 5, a4 would be at 7, and so on. Right, so this is done in line number 25, and similar processing is done for the second audio signals, where we generate again an array or a vector of zeros, and then at even values. Over here we have done on the odd values, now we will do the same thing on the even values, and for that we would get y2, which would be equal to simply y2. So this would be equal to, say, our elements are now in terms of c, so c1, 0, c2, and so on. Right, so but both of them would have the same dimensions. So let us increment the simulation by one step. Now we have whose y1 of p and y2 of p, that is the processed y1 of p and y2 of p, which is mentioned over here. So both of them are a row vector, that is 1 by this many columns, and again y2 of p is 1 times this many columns. Note that this number is achieved if you multiply y2, that is 252432, into 2, because stereo, so it will become 5000 something, and then the same number of element, that is 5000, you are putting them on alternate recursions, that is 0 value, 0 value, 0 value, and so on. So 5000 into 2 would give you this number, right? So 252432 into 2 into 2 is going to give you 1009728. Note the values which are separated by zeros for y1 of p and the values which are separated by y2 of p. In y1 of p, the first value is 0.035, whereas the second value is 0, whereas in y2 of p, the first value is 0 and the second value is 0.305. Next, in line number 33, for the interleaving part, what I have done is I have selected all the values until here. That is for the, say, left audio signal, right? And similarly, the left audio signals for drum 2. This was left audio music 1, and this is for music number 2, right? And then I have added them. Then this array would be a1, c1, a2, c2, and so on. Presently this is in a row form, and I need it in a column form, so I would transpose it. So if you transpose it, you would get A1, C1, A2, C2, and so on, AN, CN. So this is our left audio signal. And similarly for the right audio signal, suppose we have B1 for the drum music 1 and D1 for the drum music 2. So we would have B2, D2, and BN. DN. Right, so this matrix is simply the interleaver 1, which has dimensions of 504864 by 2. Note that the rows have been doubled as compared to the original Y1 or Y2 because now we have included both of them at recursion. So initially we have A1, A2 and so on, but now we have both the musics interlaid together, that is A1, C1, A2, C2 and so on. Right. Let us play the interleaved sound at 2 times the sampling frequency so that the overall time duration remains the same. So this is the interleaved signal. Now for recovery, Y1 or X expressed in line number 35. So what we need to do is we need to select A1 and set it over here. A2, B2, that is this row, and so on, AN, BN. So this is done by means of line number 39. That is interleave 1, increment of 2 to end minus 1. So it is going to pick this value and then this value and so on. And similarly for Y2 or X, we are going to start at 2. That means we are going to start at the index 2 over here. And this would be relayed something like C1, D1. C2, D2 and so on. So the recovered Y1 and Y2 is going to be played next. And Y2. So as a summary, we started with two different audio files. Make them equivalent in terms of the number of samples, did some pre-processing, interleaved them, and then recovered the original signals.